सब्सक्राइब कीजिए नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट टेक्नोलॉजी और एजुकेशनल वीडियोस सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो एवरीवन, वंस अगेन वेलकम टू अवर नेहरा क्लासेस यूट्यूब चैनल एंड आई एम योर फ्रेंड विकास नेहरा हेयर। फ्रेंड्स, इन टुडेज ट्यूटोरियल आई विल शो यू हाउ कैन यू कॉन्फिगर एन अपाचे बेस्ड यम ऑब्लिक DNF रेपोजिटरी ऑन RHEL 8 और ऑन CentOS 8 बेस्ड मशीन्स। This is the method by which we can create the YUM server in our network to install the packages on the client machine. For today's tutorial, I am going to use this RHEL 8 machine on which I will configure the DNF / YUM server, and after that I will configure the clients which will access this YUM server to install the packages on them. So for today's tutorial, I will first configure the local YUM repository on this machine, and after that I will create the Apache server to install the packages on the other clients. So without wasting time, let's get started. To create the repository on RHEL 8, we will first mount the ISO image on /mnt directory. So with this command, we can mount it. It will be mounted read-only in read-only mode. You can verify the same with the help of df-st command. There you can see that dev-sr0, which is mounted over /mnt. In the next step, we will move all the present repository files in /tmp directory. So with this command, what we are going to do, we are just going to move the present repository files in the /tmp directory. Now if we will go inside /etc/yum.repos.d directory and long list the contents, there you will find zero files. So we have successfully moved them. Now in the next step, we will create a directory over root with the name as local_repo, or you can give any name whatever you want. So with this, I have created a repository over root directory with the name as local repo. This is the directory which I have created just now. Now in the next step, we will create a file inside /etc/yum.repos.d directory with any name, but the extension should be .repo. This repository file is very important because with this file we will create the repository in our system. So this is the repo file. So with this command, we have created the repo file with the name as local-dvd-rom.repo. Now we will set the appropriate permissions on this file with the help of chmod command. Chmod read write for the user, read for the group, and only read permission for the others. With this command, we will set the permissions on the file that we have created in the previous command. Now in the next step, we will copy the contents from the ISO image that is mounted over /mnt from mnt to the directory which we have created, that is local_repo. So we will first move inside the mnt directory, cd mnt, and then if here you will long list the contents, you will find a lot of files and directories here. These are the files and directories which are present in our ISO image. So we are going to copy all this stuff to local_repo directory that we have created in the previous command. Either you can use the cp command to copy the files and directories, or you can use the star command. So I'm going to use the star command because it will show us the progress. So with this command, we will copy all these files and directories, including the packages, to local_repo directory, and this process is going to take about 5 to 10 minutes depending upon the speed of your system. So I am going to pause the video for this duration, otherwise the video will become very long. So the packages have been successfully copied. Now we will verify the packages, and for that we can run ls-l command / create repo to list the packages in / repo directory. So there you can see all these details, all these files and directories, including the packages which were there in the ISO image. It means we have successfully copied all the files and directories here. Now we will configure the local yum repository here, and for that we can open the repo file in the vi editor. The location is /etc/yum.repos.d and the name of the file is local-dvd-rom.repo. In this file, since this is an empty file, here go in the insert mode and paste all these details of the repositories. I will provide you all this stuff in the description of the video, so you can copy this from there. And now we can save this file. So we have created the repo file for the repository. Now we can run the yum repo list command to check whether it is working or not. So it is showing both the streams, app stream as well as base OS for our repository. Now in the next step, we need to install few packages that are required for creating, configuring and managing the local repository. And for that, we can install create repo and yumutil packages from the repository that we have configured. So we can use yum install create repo yumutils command to install these packages in our machine. So you can see that the installation has begun and the packages are getting installed in the machine. All the packages have been installed in our system. Now finally we can create the repository with the help of create repo command. So here we can run create repo, and then we will have to provide the directory path where we have copied all the files and directories, that is local repo. So it will create the repo in our system, and this process will take again 5 to 10 minutes. So again I am going to pause the video till it gets completed. The process has been completed and the repository has been created. Now in the next step, we can clean up the temporary repository files with the dnf clean all command, and after that we will verify that the local repository that we have created is enabled, and for that we can run yum repo list or dnf repo list command. So it is enabled. You can run any of these commands on RHEL 8, dnf repo list or yum repo list, both will show you the same results. Now in the next step, we will verify that the local repository was created. So we will check for the repo data, and we can for that we can list the repo data directory that is inside local repo directory which we have created earlier. So here it should show us these files, zipped files here, including repon.xml. So we are good to proceed further. Now we will disable the subscription warning. If you don't want this, you can skip this step because there is no issues. It will only show us a warning if you will not disable it. So here open this file in the VI editor and make it 0 from 1. So we have disabled the subscription warning. Now we will install the Apache server, and for that we can install the httpd package in our system. yum install httpd. So this command will install the httpd package in our machine that is required for creating the Apache server. The package is being installed in the system. This process will take hardly 30 to 40 seconds. So you can see that we have successfully installed the package. Now we will start the services. Systemctl start httpd. So this will start the httpd service in our system. Once the service is started, then we will enable it to set it at the boot time. So we have started the service. Now we are going to enable the service so that the service can run at its own even after rebooting the server. So we have enabled it as well. Now we can verify the status of the service with the help of systemctl status command. The service is up and running. We are good to proceed further. Now, after checking the status, we can add the Apache in the firewall so that the other machines on the network can access the yum server using the Apache. And for that we can run firewall cmd hyphen hyphen zone is equal to public hyphen hyphen permanent hyphen hyphen add hyphen is equal to http. I have already enabled it. I have already added this in the firewall, so it might show us that this service is already added. We will add both of the services, http as well as https. Actually firewall is not running, so first we need to start the firewall. Systemctl restart firewall. We have started the firewall. Now we will add the services again. It is already added. Now I will add https service. It was also already added. Now I'm going to reload the firewall with the updated rule, firewall cmd hyphen hyphen reload. So we can proceed further. Now we will verify whether the Apache is up and running. So what we are going to do, we are just going to use the IP address of our machine to open it in the web browser. So here with the ifconfig command you can see the IP address of your server, and in my case that is 192.168.1.109. Now you can open any browser on the same local area network, and if you will mention this IP address in the address bar of the browser, then it will show you the default Apache page. So I'm going to mention the IP address of my server here in the address bar of the browser, and it will show us the default Apache web page. It means we have configured everything correctly. Now we can proceed further. Now our next step would be to make the changes in the default configuration file that is inside etc httpd conf directory with the name as httpd.conf. And here we have to mention these details: document root that should be local repo instead of the default one, and then we will provide the directory that is local repo options. So copy all this stuff here and paste it here. I have already pasted it, and save this file. Now in the next step, what needs to be done? We need to restart the httpd service. Service has been started again, and now we can check the status of the service with the help of systemctl status command. Service is up and running fine. It means we can proceed further. Now we can remove the welcome page from the etc httpd conf.d directory, and the name of the page is welcome.conf. So we can use rm-rf command for that. So we have successfully removed the page, and now we can test the httpd with the help of httpd-t command. So it should show us the syntax as okay. Now in the next step, we have to set the proper permissions along with the SE Linux, because the directory that we have created is having the different SE Linux context. Let me show you. If you will run this ls-z command on var-wstml and see, see the context. So this is the SE Linux context on the default directory of the Apache. But if you will use the same command to check the SE Linux context on the directory that we have created, it may be slightly different. So with the appropriate permissions here, and to do that, we can use this set facl command to set the permissions with the help of acl. So here, set facl hyphen r hyphen m u, then username apache, read write execute, and the repo directory, that is local repo. So we have set the permission. Now we will check whether the SE Linux is enforcing or not with the help of get enforce command. It should be enforcing, because if it would not be enforcing, then the files will not be served from the repository. Now we have to change the SE Linux context of local repo directory. So with the help of chown command, we will change the context. So we have set the correct SE Linux context here. And if the SE Linux is not enforcing, then we can enforce it by using the set enforce command. In my case, it is already in enforcing mode, so I'm not going to run this command. So we have successfully set the RHEL8 DNF server based on Apache. Now we will configure the clients, and I will show you how can you install the packages on the clients. First, let me install a package here from the repository, and for that we can run the DNF install command, dnf install hyphen y vsftpd. This is the package for the FTP server. So in our server, the repository that we have created is working perfectly, and we are able to install the packages with the help of this repository. Now it is the time to configure the clients. Before configuring the client machines, let me verify whether my repository is available on the Apache web server or not, means whether we are able to access it on our web browser. So here, if we will mention the IP address of my web server, that is 192.168.1.109 in my case. So here it will show us all the files which are there in the local repo directory. So here we are able to see all the files and directories that are present inside our local repo directory. It means we have properly configured the YUM server in our network. Now to configure the clients, we have to log in on the client machine and create the repository file there inside /etc/yum.repos.d. With that file, we will create the repository and install the packages. So let's move towards the client machines. To configure the YUM client on the machine, we have to log in on the machine as the root user, and after that you have to create the repo file there. So here I'm using the CentOS 8 machine on which I will configure the YUM client, and this machine will access the packages from the YUM server. Whatever packages are required to be installed here, that can be easily installed with the help of YUM server that we have created earlier. Now to create the repo file, we can use the vi editor, vim/etc/yum.repos.d, and the name of the file with which you want to create a file here, but the extension should be .repo. Create a file here, go in the insert mode, and just mention the details like name, enabled gpg check, and base URL for our YUM server. In the base, make sure that in the base URL, you mention the correct IP address of your server, http://, and then the IP address, that is 192.168.1.109, and save this file. After that, we will verify the configuration with the help of yum repolist or the dnf repolist command. So this command will show you the repositories that are currently enabled on your system. You can run either dnf or yum repolist command, whatever you want, because both of the commands work on RHEL or on CentOS 8. Now we will verify whether we are able to install the packages from the yum server on our client machine or not. So I'm going to install a package named as vsftpd in my client machine from the yum server. So I can use yum install vsftpd command for that. And here you will see that the package is getting installed from the yum server that we have configured earlier. So in this way, we can easily configure the Apache based yum server in our network, and we can configure the clients accordingly to install the packages from that yum server. So guys, I hope that from today's session you would have understood the concept of creating Apache based yum server on RHEL 8 or on CentOS 8 based machines. If you like my hard work, then give a like to this video. Do share it with your friends and colleagues. And if you are new on our channel, then please subscribe our channel and turn on the bell notification. I will keep such videos coming for you guys, and will keep providing you the support over our Telegram channel. And if you are not there, then do join us on Telegram as well. I will see you in any other session. Till then, bye bye. Jai Hind, Vande Mataram. Take care, everyone.